हेलो मुनीना, यू मे स्टार्ट। एक्सपर्ट इज देयर राइट नाउ, सो यू मे स्टार्ट।
ओके सर, ओके सर। गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल एंड वेलकम टू द थर्ड सेशन ऑफ द डे। नाउ आई वुड लाइक टू वेलकम आवर रिस्पेक्टिव स्पीकर प्रोफेसर एनबी उमरविया सर टू शेयर हिज एक्सपर्टीज ऑन द स्टडी ऑफ बिहेवियर ऑफ सीएफजी पाइल इन द सॉफ्ट ग्राउंड। Professor N.B. Uravia is working as an assistant professor at Government Engineering College, Dahod since 2016. Sir has 13 years of teaching experience and 2 years of industrial experience. Sir has completed his bachelor's degree from M.S. University of Baroda in the year 2005, completed master's degree from Sardar Vallabhbhai National Institute of Technology, Surat in the year 2008. Sir has pursued his PhD from SVNIT Surat under the supervision of Professor Dr. C.H. Solanki sir. Sir has published more than 9 technical papers in national, international reputed conferences and journals. Sir guided 56 UG and 8 master's students. Sir has completed the project of development of soil testing laboratory for evaluating the bearing capacity of soil at a small scale. Sir has taken part in more than 30 training programs in the area of soil mechanics and foundation engineering, structural engineering. Now, all the participants are requested to keep their mics mute. If there are any queries regarding the session, please write in the comment section. Thank you, sir. You may start now.
Good afternoon, one and all. Am I audible, sir?
Perfectly audible. You may continue, sir.
Okay, sir. So good afternoon to all participants. I first of all, I congratulate to all the organizer committee team who arranged this excellent advanced FDP training programs. Okay, fundamental of the geotechnical and structural engineering for sustainable the infrastructure development. Okay. Today I'm going to present my research work. So this is my slide. I think the slide is visible. I hope so. So again, my sincerely thanks to my Dr. KB Parikh sir, Dr. YK Tendulkar sir, my coordinators, the FDP coordinators, give me this opportunity to share my the research experience journey from the beginning to end. At the start of my research, okay, I am first of all appointed as an assistant professor at the Government Engineering College, Dahod. Before that, I am working as an assistant professor in C.K. Pithavala College of Engineering. Okay, and my journey of this research work is beginning with this Government Engineering College, Dahod. I again the special thanks to my guide. Okay, without of him support and without but I could not be able to do the work, okay, which is not facility available here, okay. But today I am going to present the study the behaviors of the CFG piles on a soft ground. Actually, before I am going to start, I just wanted to say that our topic of the FDP, fundamental of the geotechnic and the structural engineering for sustainable infrastructure development. Hence, if I split out this word into the part of that fundamentals of the geotechnical, so if you need to be construct any kind of the superstructures, you have to know about its geotechnical aspect. You have to know the geotechnical property. You have to know the all the basic informations which is related to our the geotechnical part. Then you are able to develop these structures who can be sustainable for the infrastructure development. My research area, which is related to study the behaviors of the CFG pile in a soft ground. Normally, what is a CFG pile? I will talk about it laterly. It is a one kind of the pile. It is a one kind of the ground improvement techniques, which we have to the use to provide the additionally the bearing capacity of the soft ground or maybe problematical soil, as well as what kind of the behaviors it maybe happens. It means if I apply the axial load, if I applied the lateral load, if I applied the load on the small group, if I applied the load on this bunch of the number of the piles, okay. So it what kind of the behaviors which may be occurs. Similarly, we have to going to study about the soft ground behaviors, the characteristic of the soft ground behaviors. Okay, now these are the flow of the presentations. Among that, I have to cover the introductions of my topic. It means what is the basic need requirement of the experimental work, as well as what I am choosing for the methodology of the study, basic the material which we have to use in a CFG pile, numerical model and experimental work. For dealing, I have to just explaining what we have to do, okay, that results as well as the discussions. And the last part is also conclusion. Actually, when my study area, which is Surat city area, the longitude and latitude of this city area is 21.1702 north and 72.8311 east. Surat city is one of the developing fastest growing city in the world from the 2019 to 2035. As we have seen that growth ratio is 9.17, Surat city, that GDP has been increased 28.5 to 126.8. now there are the many infrastructures are development, like as a cable street bridge. Surat railway station is now the updating and advanced railway station has to be going to be developed. BRTS nowadays also, the metro railway stations, metro train corridor is also pass in Surat city, and some of the heritage buildings are there. Also, this Surat city is defined as a flyover bridge city. Maximum the bridge are there, but when I look. There are also not, it is urban apart, but as well as when I look out, the apart from the city area that is the nearest, the huge amount of the industrial is established. This industry are like as Hazira, L&T, SR Steel, Reliance, ABG Shipyard, ONGC, and many more industries are already situated. This all the industry need to be the expansion of their own the land area. They need to be developing of their industrial growth, as well as our the Surat cities also do the industrial growth is required. So what is actually the problem is creating? The problem is creating is that when I look to the soil map of the Gujarat, there are the soil of the Surat region. It is very problematic. It means it is this soil. It is a deep black clay soil. This deep black clay soils is deeply situated, and it is also defined as a black cotton soil. In geotechnical aspect, the black cotton soil is also defined as one of the problematic soils. It is a problematic soil because of its nature of the swelling and the sinkage behaviors when it is a contact with the amount of the water. Here, the monomolite, the minerals are availability in a clay. Due to these reasons, their expansions and the contractions of the soil behaviors has been occurred. These soils, the bearing capacity and its resistivity is very low comparison to other soils. So when I'm going to construct of my structures, when I deal the structure with the heavy load and these types of the soils, I have to do the soil improvement technique. Various techniques are available in over the geotechnical solutions. These various techniques, along with that, we are preferred for the purpose as well as the constructions methodology requirement. We have to choose like that. First thing, if I'm going to construct of the road, okay, there is a shallow depth. The stress distributions as well as the shallow depth, I have to improve with using the lime injecting, chemical injectings, okay, the replacement of the soils, or maybe providing some additional extra material who having the good bearing capacity. So this is one of the solutions. And the second solutions, if my structure load is too much heavy and it cannot be resist, it cannot be distribute the load, So the problems has to be creating, like as the failures of the buildings, it may be collapse, or maybe structures may be going to damage. It's like that, okay? But what is the solutions? It is compulsory to do, I already told you, it is compulsory to do the compact soil improvement technique. Various techniques like as the heavy compactions, cement grouting, deep mixing columns, column technology, embedded pile, and the our ordinary pile has to be constructed. This kind of the our techniques, any one of these choose, okay, this technique has to be used. Our topic, it is the CFG piles, as well as the CFG pile and the widely used in India, that is the enhanced stone columns. What are the difference between it? In the stone columns, the crushed stones with the size range should be 20 mm to 40 mm, where to use as a stone column material. Additionally, the reinforcement screws to be vertically enhanced, the stone columns are typically constructed with the tensile strength of up to the 400 kN per meters over the column, with the diameter range should be 40 to 200 centimeters in the practice to construct of the enhanced stone columns. Enhanced stone columns and CFG piles, both it is a column technology, ground improvement techniques. Both is effectively, both having that advantages and both having that disadvantages. My research area, our work, it is based on the cement fly ash and graveling. But in India, this enhanced stone columns is widely used because of its natures and it's easy to construction. Hence, the amount of this enhancing stone column when I provide the geosynthetic, similarly to nearest the cost of the cement fly ash and gravel pile. CFG pile is defined as a CFG pile. Cement fly ash and gravel pile is in short name is a CFG pile. The basic material like as a cement, fly ash, crushed stones, and stone chips and sand, if it is required, are mixed with the adequate amount of the water and creating the CFG piles with the high bond strength, and the strength should be the range between the C5 to C3, where the C is a mixed design. So descriptions about installations of the enhanced stone columns as well as the installations of the CFG pile constructions. The majorly it may be divided into the three part. Okay, A, first of all, it is excavations by the heavy compaction machines. Okay, either there is a providing to be a casing, so we have to provide. Otherwise, if the casing is not to be providing, okay, first of all, it is excavated with using the heavy equipment. Then after, very carefully insert the enhanced the geosynthetic materials, and the third part, to pour the stone chips and the stone aggregate, and then over the construction of the stone and her stone column is over. Now, this method we have described into be part of the flow chart and her stone columns. So first it is a first we have to do the drilling. Okay, first of all, the selecting the desirable and the ground condition is very soft. Okay, ground cannot be resist the heavy. So you need to be improve this ground bearing capacity with using the enhanced stone columns. What you have to do, you selecting the first of all the whatever the desirable the locations. Okay, then after the drilling enhance this geosynthetic penetrations of the prop, installations of the stone. Now then after the feeding the positions, if the feeding of the positions using the granular material, consolidations of this granular fill is most important. If we have to not do the consolidations, the voids are present and it's a resistivity, it may be going to be decreased. These consolidations of the granular fills finish the crushing layers and check the before the acceptance. When it is constructed after that, it is need to be checked its capacity to axial load resistivity. Similarly, if I'm going to be study about the CFG piles installation process, so first of all, we need to be the level or leveling of the grounds as well as the seating out. Then after, pile machines at the positions where we have to do the excavations of this pile. Then after the drilling, the drilling the pipe into the desirable depth. Hence, these piles, it is required to which amount, which depth we have to transfer over the load. So that's why the desirable depth, it is depending upon the over the design methodology as well as the amount of the load. Concretely, pumping the drill pipe with the load. Hence, when you have to do the concreting, the time the casing pipe we have to inserting, when we are dealing with the CFG pile, it is a mixing of the cement, fly ash and the gravels. Okay, and some of the amount of the sand, it is a finer particles which we have to require. When we are pouring this concreting, then after the pouring, some of the amount, it is withdrawal the pipe the vertically. Now the leveling the pipe in a certain height above the its desirable elevations, which is the less than of the 0.5 meter. Move to machines in the next positions and repeated this process. Okay, as the over in a square positions or maybe in a triangular positions. Both the condition and how stone columns as well as in a CFG pile installations, both is a constructed in the difference pattern. And this pattern either may be the square pattern or either it may be the in a triangular patterns. So very simple way, the CFG pile constructions method, it is divided into the three basic steps. First is the spotting, it means the locations, we fix up over the excavations, heavy equipments, drilling, after the drilling, pour the concrete and then lift up the concrete. So this is the very simple way to construct them and installations of our CFG pipe. Measurely application, actually this enhanced stone column is used in India very widely to enhancing the ground improvement anchoring, second thing to enhance the bearing capacity as well as to transfer the load. But in China, the CFG piles technology is widely used for the providing the tank foundation, slope foundations, footing isolations, railway foundations, retaining walls, and the highway constructions. So these are the majorly applications they have to widely use. But yeah, this research area is very less. That's why the need of the research based on the CFG pile. In a CFG pile, we are not using any kind of the reinforcement. Without the reinforcement, okay, the adequate amount of the cement, fly ash and the gravel mix can be the use. Now, if I'm started with my journey of the research, there is a lot of the questions are creating in the mind. Okay, how do we can be the do? Okay, which types of the method we have to select in? Okay, if I choose the empirical methods, if I choose the experiment work, if I choose the numerical methods. So these times, the every researchers, one of the thing is help that, what is the design experiment we have to do? What is the design experiment? All over the idea about the new products, new services, new futures, any changes we can introduce to make the things better, growth, revenge, experience, etc. Start as an idea, hypothesis and assumptions in the traditional approaches. One will be based on some of the RO analysis or the investigation analysis, making the further assumptions in this process that will be known as the design of the experiment work. When we are going to design of the experiment work, the alternative approach can be the and be applied. If we can be the apply the alternative approaches, what kind of the expectations of the results may be come out? What kind of lessons I have to consider? So this kind of the lot of the questions has to be created. When if you are the researchers and you need to be do the some experiment work, you choose the Taguchi method. In the Taguchi methods, okay, you can be the shortly and the selecting your experiment work. Okay, so these are the my suggestions. Some of the those object of the experiment work we may wanted to keep open until we get the real the world proof which can be the done the split tail side for the examples. Now then after, why do the design of the experiment work? Every researcher is having the questions. This the design experiment work is the fail safe way to advance the solutions and they learn the fast. Design of experiment work can provide the quick way to evaluate the product. design of experiment helps to drive the innovations in exciting as well as the new product. Design the experiment enable the autonomous terms to deliver on the leadership intents by the placing the small specs. Design of experimental is essentially for the releasing and the line, the measure, the learn, the loops. These are the over the why we are do the experiment work. I also design of my experiment work. My experiment work, I started with the very small scale because this technique, it is a use wide range. If I'm going to selecting and selecting the any soft ground, but it is not possible for me because I'm here in the Dahod and Dahod region, the hard strata is available. So here the simple building is raised on the 5 to 7 feet below the foundation should be raised on the from the ground to 5 to 7 feet, and it is easily to transfer the load. These are the majorly. So here, if I wanted to do the experiment in a larger scale, it is not possible for me. So I'm just going to decrease my the scale in the both the case, okay, in a size of the pile as well as in a softening of the soils, okay. So this is the way of to be the design of my experiment. So when we are going to be test for the evaluation of the bearing capacity, which methods we are going to select, the predictions of the actual capacity of the pile as well as the lateral capacity of the piles, the below the mentioned approach, majorly the mentioned approach we have to going to select in the geotechnical engineering practice. Interpretations of the data with the full scale pile load testing, static analysis, utilization of the soil parameters, method using of the in situ test, one of the pile driven analysis, and the recommendation of the dynamic formula. Normally, when we check the actual capacity of the any kind of the pile, either it is maybe stone columns or either it may be CFG pile, after the installations, okay, the 5 to 7% of the pile selecting and tested, okay, if it having the good bearing capacity to take a good load, one of the test it is compulsory to do, okay. So the setups, I just small scale up. In this small scale up, I considering one circular tank, most the thickness of this ionic plate having the more than of the 100 mm thick. So the soil pressures cannot be affected on the boundary of this one. Here the loading frame, measured the loading frame, load cell having the capacity of the 100 kilonewtons, ionic tank 300 mm diameters, hydrolyzer I have to use to apply the axial load, LVDT, okay, to LVDT I have to use, so it is vertically, axial load is applied parallelly on both the side, that's why the two LVDT I have to set up, and majorly here the part of this loading frame to apply the load. Hydraulic jack, using this hydraulic jack, the whatever amount of the load which is come from the loading frame to transfer easily to a CFG pile, and the what amount of the load we apply, this load is measured by the load cell. Load cells having the capacity of the 100 kilonewton. So when we applied the load on the single CFG piles, 100 kilonewtons more than, okay, it can be the resistance. So what amount of the requirement? This is the experimental setup, and now I make the my experiment work. What basic the material I need? I need the clay. Here the clay, it is very hard, so I have to collecting the soil from the Surat region as well as the from the where the soil having the problematic soils, the gravel which I have considered, which is locally available, having the basalt stones, okay, the cement, sand and aggregate which we require to making our the mix and the fly ash. I have a I have collected these flyers from the Vanakuri and selecting the two different flyers, as well as when I choose the gravel for using to make the CFG pile, I choose the two different size of the gravels. We literally talk on that. So when I choose, when I deal my geotechnical experiment work with the soil, it is compulsory to know the parameters of its physical parameters. The physical parameters which we have to define it, like as a particle size analysis, it's a plasticity index, it's a liquidity index, okay, shrinkage index. When I analyze according that, a natural low plasticity clay was excavated from the depth of the 1 meter below the ground level. The site is located near the Dahod district, Gujarat. The dry and pulverized samples was throughout, and these are the particle size distributions curves. Okay, it is ununiformatically and it is a overregulated. So particle size here, clay amount of the presence, okay, 40 from the 0.075 and below that, okay, the maximum the particles has been to pass out, 75 more than, so it is defined as a clay. Now another experiment to know the basic parameters of the soils, physical property, it is requirement that to compaction test. What is a compaction? Compaction, it is a, we take the soils, okay, we have to pass these soils from the 2 mm sieves. Then after, different amount of the water we have to add in a soil. Then after, apply the hammer load, okay, and a circular hammer load we have to apply and do the compactions. After that, we need to be checked with the needle and the finding out its density. So there is a relation between the dry density versus the water content. When I increase from the 9, 11, 13, okay, 15, 17, and many more. So I have to find that nearest to the 14% of the water content amount that I achieving the dry density of this soil is a maximum. Some of the basic the property which I have to find out. In this basic property, it is a natural water content is a 14%, specific gravity is a 2.614, maximum dry density of the unit weight of the clay is 19, bulk unit weight is a 21.6, liquid limit is a 19, plastic limit is very nearest to zero, that's why zero, plasticity index is a 29.5, okay, G1 2. There are another two different the gravel we have to choose, there is a G1 and G2, G1 and G2. I could discuss about that. Okay, one G1, it is a the grid, the particle size which we have to the use for the making of the CFG pile. This CFG piles particle size I am going to reduce. Normally in a constructions, the aggregate is a use, the range it is a 20 mm to 25 mm. But when I reducing my scale, we need to be decreasing the amount size of the grid. So that's why the size of the grid range, first of all selecting the less than the 10 mm, 10 mm less than 10 mm to 6.75 mm, and the 6.75 mm to 4.75 mm. So this both the range, it is identified as the G1 and G2. So specific gravity of this particle size as well as the bulk unit weight, okay, CC and CU. So these are the particle size distribution of the G1 and G2. Now the selecting of the material, difference material to making the concrete mix or maybe our CFG pile mix, I preferred as ordinary cement, because nowadays the PPC cement having the some amount of the fly ash in the prism, that's why I'm not achieving the grade of particularly when I use this PPC cement. So that's why I choose the ordinary cement used for the all the experiment work, which is selected based on the IS 269 2015 sand, and the gravel collect from the local quarry and the river sand supplier has been the use of the experiment work. This selection is based on the IS 383 2016. However, The fine aggregate is obtained from the natural disintegrations of the rock is used. It is as a good as a alluvial sand. Moreover, based on the IS, this fine aggregate should be the pass from the 4.75 mm sieve. The further the size of the aggregate, 20 mm, which we have to use. Another parameters of the soils, okay, when I choose of the 50 grade OPC cement, the specific gravity surface should be 345 meter square per kg. Initial setting times of the cement is a 42 minutes and final setting times of this cement is a 165. While when choosing of the cement BPC, their specific surface is a 332 square meter per kg. Initial setting time 62. So here the initial setting time is too much high. That's why I'm not choosing this PPC cement. Final setting time is a 212. The sounding test is a 1. Okay, as the IS 12269, the range of the specific surface, initial setting time, final setting time, and sounding test are the mentioned here. So materials which we have to select in as per the base IS 3812-2016, depending upon the chemical and physical property of fly ash, has been disintegrated into the two grades. First is the grade 1 and grade 2. This fly ash is a two different grade. One is identified for the grade 1 is a black, and second is a grade 2. Because the collecting, the starting of the collections of my fly ash from the SR steel plants Hazira, okay, these two different fly ash, which is one is a grade 1 and second one is a grade 2. The particle size of the analysis of the fly ash, okay, grade 1 and grade 2. Here this particle size analysis is most important because of the when I adding this fly ash and achieving the strength from the C5 to C20. Over this study area is based on the C20 mix design. So it is compulsory to need the physical property as well as the particle size analysis of the fly ash must be necessary. These are the physical properties of the fly ash from the grade 1 and grade 2. Specific gravity is 1.55. Grain size percentage gravel is 0. Percentage sand 25%. Silt and clay is 75%. Maximum dry density, dry unit weight is 13.21 of the grade 1. Optimum moisture content 21.5. Fineness 312. Particle retains on the 45 microns IS sieve. Wet sieving 22%. While in a considering of the grade 2, it is off white colors 1.89, 0, 32, 68, 12.21. Optimum moisture content 20.5. Fineness 276 and the particle retains on 45 microns IS sieves is a 26%. Now, before I'm going to construct casting of my CFG pile, I need to be choose the grade of these different ingredients. Here the different ingredients that we have used as a cement, sand, gravel, and fly ash. The author of the Shuang Yut et al. 2016, the author give one the proposals of these CFG piles which they have a use of first part of the cement 4.2 sand 5.13 gravels and choosing of the 0.5% of the fly ash and here they have a use of the water reducing agent 3.09. The water contain they have a use 0.51. So based on this study references, I do my trial and error method and finding out the grade of the different cement, sand, and fly ash and gravel. The first part of one part of the cement, 3.2 part of the sand, 4.13 part of the gravel, 0.51 of the fly ash, and here I am not using of the water reduction agents. That's why the water 15 units. The unit weight which you are considering, which I have to mention here, 265, 848 kg per meter cube, 1094 kg per meter cube for gravel, fly ash 135. So these are the some of the photograph of the casting of CFG piles at SNIT. Okay, and then I use the different grid as well as the different time durations of the fly ash grade 1 and grade 2 with the different references. So with using of the OPC cement, after the 14 days I have achieving the 25.8, and after the 28 days I achieving the 27.3. so as per the over the OPC cement the ratio of the 1:3.2:4.13:2.51:2.59, these proportionals we have to use throughout the over the experimental work in a making of this CFG piles. Now second thing is that when soils having that their soils it's a nature to resistivity, basically the shear resistivity based on the two parameters. First is the cohesiveness and second one is the angle of internal frictions. When I wanted to do my experiment work, I have to modify of my soil characteristic. It means I have to decreasing its a shearing capacity, then making the soft soils. So there are the two part. First thing is that if I'm adding the water amount, so due to this amount of the water increasing, decreasing its a shearing strength. So how we have to be selecting this amount, this much amount of I'm adding the water. Okay, that amount of the water which we know is optimum doses of the water adding, and select and this water amount of this water reducing the shearing capacity of the soil. So need to be do the unconfined compressive strength, make the samples, okay, with the different amount of the water and check its a shearing capacity. So these are the few of the results, okay, using the before the preparation of the soft clay bed in order to determination of the shear strength of the soils of the experiment work. In essentially prepare the unconfined compressive strength samples using the different water content. So USCS samples 3.8 cm diameter and 7.6 cm height, their amount of the water, the soil weight, amount of the water we had adding after the 28 days. Okay, we have to check. So here over the study area it is a 7 days as well as the 28 days, but over the interested area when I casted my CFG piles after the 7 days, I have to apply the load and what amount of the load, the capacity that I have to measure. That is my main object. So another test it is compulsory to do for the soil for your surety, that is a when shear test. In this when shear test, amount of the water is a 20%, 25%, or 30%. So you have to check the CU value, and you got the value of that. If I'm adding the 20% of the water content, I got the CU value is a 56.7 kPa. When adding the water of the 25, 9.46. So this is drastically the decreasing the CU value. And as per the UCS shear test results, if I'm adding the 23% of amount of the water, it's a shearing strength is a 13.01 kPa. Okay, so hence why we are doing this amount of the water. Normally the soils having the two parameters, as we know the shear parameters, first is the cohesiveness and second one is the angle of internal frictions. With adding amount of the waters, this shearing capacity between the particles has to be reduced, and that's why it's becoming soft and the shearing strength should be decreasing. One thing is that what is a soft soil? Soft soil, it is a defined whose the shearing capacity is less than of the 15 kPa, that soil is identified as over the soft soil. So that's why the 23% of the amount of the water it is referred to making the soft clay bed. So over the experimental setups, now we detailly study about that. For the experimental, a scale model of the statically loading test of the pile may be offered, a more economical options than the corresponding the full scale test. When I selecting this reducing scale of the experiment work, I do the maximum experiment work. Second things, if my experiment is failing, I can do the re-experiment of this schedule. So this is one of the things is that experimental setups. The axial static, the file load test on the scale models you are choosing, okay, reducing the scale, all the tests. Mainly the three tests has been the performance of the CFG file. First thing is the test on a soft soil bed, which is the first part. This is my first part, okay. Soft soil clay bed test on the 70 mm and 100 mm, the diameter of the single CFG files with the end bearing and the fixed length. The test on the 70 mm and 100 mm, the diameter single CFG file with the variable floating length with the effective variable L by D ratio. So these are the schematical diagrams of the single CFG file test. Load is applied by the jack, and this load is come from the over the loading frame. Loading frame having the capacity of the 10 ton. So it is very too much heavy. If need the additional load, we can do the fix up or maybe the put up the dead weight on it. Second, the load cell, the functions to take a reading for the amount of the actual load, LVDT to measure the displacement, the tank, okay, the height. Actually, the tank length, the full length is 600 mm, and the diameter, inner diameter is 290 mm. The experimental work of the difference number test for the actually loaded test on the single CFG pile, the diameter of the CFG pile is 70 mm, 100 mm. Hence, their length of the CFG pile is 500 mm. Their L by D ratio, here, the end bearing pile, we have to use, that's why the L by D ratio is considering. L by D ratio is not considering, it is end bearing pile. Majorly, the pile having the two natures. First is the end bearing pile. It means the soil, it means that over the pile is easily transferred. Load come from the superstructures to hard strata. This type of the pile is identified as an end bearing pile. Second thing is that floating pile. If my soil deeply, my soil strata is a deeply black water soils, there is no hard strata is available below the deeper depth. So these conditions, we have to provide as a friction piles or maybe the friction or maybe floating piles. So these are the experimental experimental schedules, programs of the single CFG piles. Okay, total the 14 experimental in this in a 70 mm 100 mm with the variable length from 175. It means their L by D ratio 2.5, 3, 3.5 and 4 and 4.5. The range we have to consider 2.5 to 4.5. This variable, the range of the floating pile has been selected. Now the another, the 70 mm, the 13 and the 14, the experiment 70 mm with using the 450 mm the length, using the gravel G1 and using the gravel G2 to determinations of its actual load carrying capacity, okay, and which one having the maximum capacity, according this gravel is a choose for the next experiment. So how do we have to prepare the clay bed? Very briefly, I have to explain here. In order from the soft clay, 23% additional of the water is required, which is based on the UCS samples undrained unconfined compressive strength. The step-wise the process has been explained as below. First steps, the bulk unit weight of the clay with a 23% water content is the 18.1 kilometer cube. Initial has the properly with the water in order to achieving the uniform the consistency. This mixture has been the covered with the plastic covers with the 36 hours. Now when I use the soil, okay, mix it properly, but I'm not to be put my soil for the gaugings and the proper the mixings of the water amount, okay. So this gauging times, okay, and how to procure this mixing with the plastic covers, so moisture cannot be the evaporated from this. Okay, that's the second thing is that. Now then after a thin coated of the grease has been applied along the inner surface of the tank wall to reduce the frictions between the clay and the walls. Then afterward, this clay has been filled in a tank up to the height of the 50 mm in order to avoid the presence of the air voids. This mixture has been completed by the. So how do we have to do the clay the preparations? Okay. If suppose I need 100 kg of the soil, so I have to divide of the 100 kg of the soils into the 4 or maybe 5 parts, equal part. Take the rice soil samples, which is already dry and pulverized, crushing from and passing through the 1 mm sieve. This soils now amount of the 23% amount of the water is adding equally, mixing with the hand properly. Now in a and keep this soil samples at the 36 hours for the mixing properly. Then after, when I insert the clay, before that inner surface of the tank 50 mm the mark has to be 50 mm marks is a fix up into the tank. Now then after the pour these soils step by step, okay, compact these soils to avoid and the removing the amount of the voids which is present in the clay. So providing using the tamping rod applied with 25 mm of the blues and formation of the clay beds in a very leveling. Then after put up the setup and check its our load versus settlement curve. Now experiment setup for the single CFT piles. So similarly over the clay bed making this process is very simple way. Then the casing pipe, okay, the plastic casing pipe, the external diameter is 70 mm and the 100 mm. Now insert this casing pipe vertically in a soft clay, the removing the inside the soil by using the auger, remove the soil, clean it inside properly, then after make this CFG pile. So here there are the A to D part is divided. A is a soft clay photograph, B is a compacting rod, hollow pipe installations, and the soil removing. The following the points have to be take care during the single CFG pile installation process. In order form of the vessel, initially the long hollow steam pipe was the push into the soft soils up to the desirable depth. Here I am using the variable the length, that's why the desirable depth is a variables in a floating pipe. Therefore the soil has to be removed using the auger. A thin coat of the grease has been applied the inner and outer surface of the hollow steam pipe to reducing the friction between the clay and the pile during the installation and the removing the process. The pile was withdrawal rate of appropriate the 5 mm per minute up to the 550 mm the height after the pouring the mixing. The after drawing of the pile head was the covered by the curing blanket for the 7 days, ensure to development its a compressive strength. This point has to be noted down. Very simple way. I have to just explain this installation's process in a 8-step. Step one, dry mix has been prepared. Second step, additionals of the water in a dry mix. Now homogeneous mix process. Fourth, preparations of the wet mix as per the mix design standard. Pouring of the wet mix through the hollow plastic pipe. Then after 25 blows of the compactions has been given of this mix. Now gradually the removal of the plastic pipe up to the 50 mm to avoid the air and voids. Easy to remove in a plastic pipe, extra material at least. Now store this for the 7 days and developing of the compressive strength. So these are the some of the steps which we have to mix. First step is a dry mix, then after adding the water, mix it properly, okay, keep it in a one bucket. Okay, pour 50 mm applied 25 number of the blow using the compactional rod, and smoothly lift up this pipe up to the after the pouring. So these are the construction steps which we have to follow. Now preparation of the test samples. The capacity of the lid loading frames of the hydrologic 5 ton and the 10 metric tons respectively. Manually the axial force has been supplied to pile through the hydraulic jack. During this manual process, the seating rate of order 0.25 mm per minute has been mentioned. During this process, the variation between the applied load and the settlement has been the recorded. So already we have to discuss this load. So what display unit load and display unit of the displacement. Load is applied by the manually like by using the hydraulic. Normally 6 cycles per minute we have to choose. The operating manually 1.25 mm per minute, that is the spin rate we have to maintain when we applied the load on this CFG pile. With the applied gradually with the manually with the hydraulic jack. And the loading plate of the arrangement using the steel bowl. Okay, so it is easily to apply the load as well as the pile diameter. According to the diameter, we put up the foundations, the plate, who can easily apply the load throughout. These are the few of the photographs of the. Now the load is on the single CFG piles. Okay, after the applied the load, the relation between the load versus the settlement is over the output. This load versus the settlement curve is a linearly and the non-linear the behaviors with the different grade and a different L by D ratio. The past experiment process, it is most necessary. During the experiment process, we should follow the steps. Some after the experiment work, we need to be follow some experiment steps. After the performing the experiment work, the soil has been removed carefully without to be the touch, without the breaking of the CFG piles or maybe the disturbance of the CFG piles. Therefore, in order to removing the soil particles very carefully, now wash the piles with the water. Afterward, the lateral displacement of the pile has been the check for the damages. Then, over the result, output the results, load versus settlement is validated with the numerical analysis has been carried out. This is the after process of the experiment work, the photograph. Okay, and you have to see that there is no damages is found in a end bearing pile. These validations of the models of each experiment work based on the over the numeric analysis of the plexus reading. One of the best paper from the Ambali and Gandhi, who conducting the experiment test on the 100 mm diameter of the stone columns surrounding by the soft clay and the height of the 450 mm in 210 mm diameter of the cylindrical tank. So Ambali and Gandhi experiment works and this reading is validated by the Murtuza Hassan's and K. Samadja sir's, and this present study is also the result is the nearest. So this error should be very less. Okay, so now come to about the part of the results analysis, the test 1 and 2. Okay, the first test, it is a soft clay test. So if you have a see here, just wait a minute, it is a non-linear behaviors of this soft clay. If I am going to make it is a tangential of the both the directions. Okay, because the soil having that capacity is very less. And the second thing, this second result, the dark line is explaining the 70 mm end bearing CFG piles. So end bearing, it's a load over, it is a resistivity capacity. Comparisons of the soft clay, it's too much high. Approximately this most the bearing capacity, it is a 53.87 nearest to that KPA, while the maximum capacity from the 0 to 50 mm maximum capacity, we got the more than of the 2000 KPA space. Here the diameter of the pile, it is a 70 mm length, should be considered as a 500 mm. This figure is explaining the actually the behaviors of the stress. So majorly the L by 3 from the top surface, it is a majorly affected of the vertical setup. Now the experiment 2 and the 3, again 2, it is over the B is a 70 mm and the length is a 500 mm. Okay, while the experiment 3 is a diameter is a 100 mm and the length is a 500 mm. So this widely different. The pattern of the failure is the same. The dotted graph, it is explaining the relation between the settlement versus the stress by taking the FEM analysis. This FEM analysis is taken from the Plexus 3D. The diameter is a 70 mm experiment work, and the diameter is a 100 mm. So there are the significant differences has to be found. Here the significant differences are found in over the 70 mm and 100 mm. One thing is that the load, if I look the load versus the settlement, the relations, the load versus settlement, the relation is the load getting me high. But when I look the stress versus the settlement, the 100 mm, the diameter of the CFG pile having the less amount of the stress concentrations comparison of the smaller diameter of the CFG piles in embedding. So the stress shading of over the length is 500 mm, D is 70 mm. Okay, so the vertical displacement, we have to see that this is a Plexus output results. Okay, L by 3 ratio from the top surface, you can got the maximum ray displacement and the horizontal displacement here, it is very less. So when we are applying the load vertically, that time its lateral displacement of the CFG pile is very negligible in this both the case 2 and case 3. Similarly, if you see the in 100 mm, 100 mm the CFG piles, single CFG piles, the end bearing piles, the very least amount of the lateral displacement has to be found under the axial. So these are the numerical analysis taken, the relation between the lateral displacement versus the depth. Yes, this reading is undulations. Okay, because the maximum there are the many numbers of the points are getting from the numerical analysis, and it is undulations due to the disturbance from the 0 to 500 mm. So maximum the lateral displacement has to be found from the top surface. The lateral displacement is the nearest to 0. Okay, from the 300 mm to 500 mm, the below the depth of the pile. Now the experimental result for the single CFG pile, case number 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. This case number 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8, which is based on the L by D ratio, and the diameter of the CFG pile is a 70 mm. The L by D ratio, as we know that what is L by D? L is the length of the CFG pile and D is the diameter of the CFG pile. So we choose according the length of its diameter is very fixed variable over 70 mm, and it is very, very significantly seen that when I going to increase the L by D ratio and its stress concentration has to be increasing with respect to limb. So here the stress from the 0 to 700 mm and the settlement 0 to 50 mm is taken. Here the LVDT having the range of the maximum is the 50 mm. That's why the 50 mm to up to that study in each and experiment work has to be considered. So it is very simple way to see that in L by D ratio is a 2.5. Okay, the patterns as well as 3, 3.5, 4, and 4.5, all having the same patterns. It is a non-linear the behaviors. It means that if I'm going to use as a tangential methods to evaluate the capacity of the CFG piles and the intersections with this tangential and getting the its bearing capacity to getting the value of the over the to get the maximum to get the bearing capacity of the pile. Similarly, okay, from the L by D 3, L by 3, 3.5, 4, and 4.5, all having the same patterns. Okay, these are the output of the test number 4, 5, 6, and 7. L having the 175 mm, that lateral displacement. Displacement. Okay, as well as the lateral displacement has to be explained with the difference. Now experimental results for the single CFG pile within a this graph is explaining the differences vertical settlement versus over the actual load. So vertical settlement shading has to be explained, as well as the stress distribution is also mentioned here. What amount of the stress has to be creating below the pile? This numerical results of the total vertical settlement shading effect has to be created. So L by D 2.5, 3, 3.5, 4, 4.5, and the legends of from the 50 mm to 0 mm has to explain its meaning. Similarly, the experimental results for the single CFG pile on 9, 10, 11, and 12. Okay, it is nothing, that is 100 mm the diameter of the CFG piles with the variables of the 2.5, 3, 3.5, and 4. In this case, I'm not selecting the 4.5 because 100 mm and my tank size having some limitations. That's why L by D ratio of the 4.5 has to be considered. Again, the same, the graph pattern has to be created. Pattern has to be creating. It is a non-linear behaviors of the each and every graph. Here, another thing I have observed that they having the some particularly the nearest amount of the increasings as the numerical relationship. We literally talk on that. These are the experimental the output from the basis 3D. Shading effect, numerical results for the total vertical settlement, the shading effect. Now the most important part of this experiment, this is my 13 and the 14 experiment is the before the experiment. Okay, which gravels we have to choose? Either I'm going to choose as a G1 gravels or either I'm going to choose as a G2 gravel. G1 gravel is identified as the particle size which is passing from the 10 mm and retained in a 6.3 mm. It means the particle size, the diameter, the range between the 10 mm to 6.3 mm. G2, particle size range between the 6.3 mm to 4.7 mm. So I'm choosing the very small of the particle size in the all the experiment because of the when it's a mix with the cement and the flyers, it give us to be the better results comparisons of the G1 particle size. So particles, smaller particle size having the good bond as well as they having the good density to resist the applied load. That's why all the experiment work we choosing the G2. It means the particle size of for experiment work is a range between 6.3 mm to 4.75 mm range. Now the end of the first part, the stress improvement factors we are going to study, SIF. SIF is defined as a stress improvement factor. The stress on the CFG pile at the 50 mm settlement as well as the stress on the clay bed at the 50 mm second. So it is seen that when I choose the length of the 500 mm, the SIF, I got the 28.75. In 100 mm, I got the SIF, stress improvement factor is a 23.14. It is very simply, we can say that when we are choosing the smaller diameter of the CFG pile, having the good stress improvement factor. In the case of the 70 mm the floating piles and 100 mm the folding pile, when we have to increase its length due to the frictional resistivity, is the stress improvement factor is increasing, the stress improvement factor from the 4.6 5.426 in case of the when L by D ratio is 2.5. When L by D ratio is 4.5, then after then that conditions, the our stress improvement factors is 7.68. Similar case in a case of the 100 mm the floating piles, the 2.5 L by D ratio, the stress improvement factor is 4.39, and in the case of the 100 mm L by D ratio is equal to 4, that time the stress improvement factor is 2.9. Some of the experimental results of the single CFG piles, it's a lateral displacement by the numerical analysis, case number 12 and case number 14. L is equal to 400 mm, L is equal to 450 mm, D is equal to 70 mm, and D is equal to 100 mm. Okay, what is the lateral displacement relationship? Okay, the graph is explained about the lateral displacement versus the depth. Over the pile, the maximum the length, according to the length, the reading has to be found. And here it is observed that it's a lateral displacement is not going to be more than of the 1 mm. Numerical results based on a single CFG piles under the lateral load. These are the cross sections of the lateral displacement to find out the output results. Now, these results and the discussions, the load carrying capacity of the soft clay beds can be enhanced by the providing the CFG piles. The load carrying capacity of the single CFG pile is about the nearest to 27% more than of the soft clay bed based on the property of the soft clay. CFG pile adopted of this research work, the column diameters has a significant influence on the load carrying capacity of the CFG piles. The load carrying capacity of the 70 mm CFG are 1.3 times more than the 100 mm CFG piles. The stress on the CFG pile increased with the increasing the L by D ratio of the pile. The maximum improvement on the stress is observed about the 40% depending upon the diameter of the pile. The load carrying capacity of the CFG piles with the smaller gravels particle size is more than the bigger size of the gravel particles. The maximum improvement is observed about the 20%. The lateral displacement of the CFG pile is significant for the all the diameters, the length, diameter, the ratio of the CFG piles and the gravel particle size of the CFG piles. So these are the summarize of this experiment part 1. Now in the case of the part 2, to apply the lateral ultimate load to check the lateral capacity of the CFG pile, in the first part I am only applying the axial loading. In the second part I have to apply the ultimate lateral load. According to the ultimate lateral load, to check its soil stress as well as to check its steady behaviors. Similarly way to study the behaviors of the CFG pile under the combination effect of the compression as well as the lateral load. It means axial load as well as the lateral load we have to apply. So these are the secondary the part applied the lateral load. Hence, in a case pile experimental setup, the same tank, same load cell, the same hydraulic jack how to use. But in the case of the lateral, the spatial arrangement which we have to carry out. In the case of the spatial arrangement, we use the bunch of the two pulley. One is a fixed at a vertically and second one is a fixed as a horizontally of this connecting. This connecting is a fixed with the cable and the cables moves the capacity to pull this load. Now very prescribable this experiment has to be defined. So here the major part, it is a pile cap collars, frictionless pulley assembles, tension cable, suspended load, steel tanks, display unit, hydraulic jack, load cells, vertical dial gauge, and already how to be applied. This experiment is only to be applied for single CFG piles, but I am going to be applied this load on to be the multiple piles and a small group of the piles. It could not be applied. So now the first part of this, now the part two, there are divided into the two part. First is only the apply the lateral load. Second part, it is a lateral load plus the axial load. The static load where the conducted on the single CFG pile per procedures mentions in the IS 2911 part 4, before the application of the lateral load, the initial reading of the LVDD is adjusted as a zero. The static lateral load were applied in increment by the additional the dead suspended weight through this load connected with the high tensile and flexible wire, during which the maximum tensile, the load capacity 30 kilonewton capacity. This was the connected the horizontally with the CFG piles head collar. High tensile strain, the flexible wire passed from the frictionless pulley. It was the with a special arrangement the made and welded with the steel pier, where one of the end is fixed with the pile and collar, while the other's end is attached with the suspended dead load. After the application of the weight lateral deflected off the CFG pile's hand, we measure the different time intervals. This system is working repeatedly until the failure of the CFG piles or specified the maximum deflection value of the 15 mm is reached. So this is the most important part, is that first thing is that this load increment we have to apply repetitively until my pile is full. Otherwise, the maximum the deflection value is reached as 15 mm. So the nearest some of the figure of the lateral load capacity to measure. So examine the spatial arrangement. One pulley is fixed as a vertically, second is a horizontally. The cable is a straightly passed through from this frictionless pulley and connected with it. Here the dead load is a suspended load. The suspended load I am going to be increasing with the particular time interval. This experiment work, it takes a time of the from the morning to evening. Either maybe it's, sometimes it's take a approximately 12 hours to 15 hours, okay, from the little bit of the deflections. So these are the experimental setups equipment. Okay, one is a digital dial gauge we have to use also for the measuring the vertical settlement, as well as the two LVDD we have to fix as a horizontally to measure the lateral displacement. Okay, in a combined load, most important thing is the second part, in a sub part of the combined loading. In a case of the combined loading, the pile cap, the collar, friction pulleys, assembles, the majorly. First is the pile cap collar. Second, it is a frictionless pulley. Tension cable is applied. Fourth is a suspended load. Steel tanks, okay, display unit, hydraulic jack, load cell, vertical dial gauge reading, as well as two LVDDs are fixed up. Here you will see that are the two LVDDs are fixed to measure the horizontal deflections under the action. When we are going to be connected with the combined load, okay, some of the special arrangement has to be fixed up. This arrangement is based on the ASTM D3966 part plate, 10 mm thick and 90 mm the length, 5 numbers, 10 mm the MS the bar are equally the distance has to be put. So when we apply the combined load, it can be the resist, what amount of the resist of the lateral load as well as friction load. This kind of the special arrangement we have to put to avoidness of the lateral. Lateral capacity. Okay, so now what is the method of the combined testing? So step by step I have to explain here. I describe the vertical load was applied the four increment and the maintained for approximately 1 hour before the apply a lateral forces. Again I repeat, a desired the vertical load was applied in a four increment Here what I am saying is that desirable type vertical load, because we already done the and find out the axial capacity of the CFG pile. So we have some references, we have some reading of the taken the vertical load. So this vertical load, desirable vertical load, we also apply 4 increment and the maintain the approximately 1 hour before they apply the lateral load. For example, I got the 100 kN of the load. So I 100 kN load, I divide into the 4 part, 25 kN, 25 kN load, 25 kN, 25 kN. So first part, I have to apply the 25 kN load, then maintain approximately the 1 hour. After that, I'm going to be applied my lateral load in these conditions. The lateral forces was applied initially by the tension cable passed from the frictionless pulley and fixed with the suspended load. The loading should be applied in a regular interval, 5% of the conditions continuously at the rate of the sufficient constant rate. Lateral displacement of the 0.01 mm per minute has the increment repeated until the fail of the CFG piles or the specific deflection value of the 15 hertz. When I applied this load, then I have to keep the suspended load of the for the some times. So here the rate of the lateral difference has to be created. Now this the rate of the displacement, lateral displacement, has to be nullified. It means 0.001 mm per minute. Then after we adding the some another weight. Okay. So this way step by step getting the value of the vertical the lateral load versus the lateral deflections value. The vertical settlement of the CFG pile is measured by the digital dial gauge, which I have already seen in our previous photograph, which position is on the top of the pile cap. At this point, the applied each incremental load was the case measured to be the respect to displacement CFG piles was to be the mentioned every 30 minutes. The lateral load was the reduced every regular interval load every 30 minutes, as I told you. Now the compression test was then reduced to 0 to 0 in a 5 decrement. When already we have to done this in a case of the combined load, applied load as well as the loading and unloading. So when the compression load was then reduced to 0 to 0 in a 5 decrement. The remaining the lateral force was the remote over the 3 minutes period. Now zero load reading was taken after the 30 minutes. So soil can be the reformations or maybe the some readjustments after the its behaviors in case of the loading. So these are the schematicals, these are the charts. Okay, the experimental has been done. The CFG pile is 70 mm, the length 175 mm. Now the axial compression load without the lateral load, with the lateral load of the 0.3, 0.6 and 0.9 with the lateral load, this lateral load H by HU as well as the in a case of the lateral loading applied without axial load, with axial load 0.3, 0.5 and 0.7 has to be considered. Okay, these are the experiment. HU is the ultimate lateral load and VU is ultimate the axial compression load is identified. So these are the few of the results. Already the actual the load capacity we already defined in the previous case. Hence, this chart is explaining the relationship between the actual compression load versus the settlement. In actual compression load, the load is defined as in the form of the Newton, while the settlement is in the form of the mm. The relation is linearly of the 70 mm because of the bearing, because of this pile is the end bearing pile. So this graph is also explaining the differences between the end bearing pile and a floating pile. So here the floating piles having the friction resistivity. This friction resistivity with the particularly the length, up to that length it is a resist the axial load. Beyond that it may be the failure. So that's why this non-linear behavior be creating in this graph, and it means that when it's changing its a path, this the pile is maybe fail up to the 10 to 8 to 10 MS. Similarly, if you have to see this the relationship between the excess compression versus the settlement, already we have to do the lateral load, the relationship between the lateral load versus the lateral displacement, or maybe the displacement. So here in this case, the CFG pile, the diameter is 70 mm, L by length is at 175, L 210, 245, 280 and 315, which is based on the different L by D ratio. Okay, here you have to see that the in a case of a small L by D ratio, having the low lateral low ultimate lateral load capacity, when increasing with the length, its lateral capacity has to be increasing. Similarly, we do the experiment work of the lateral load versus the displacement of the L is equal to 500 mm, diameter is equal to 100 mm, and the 70 mm, to see the difference between two lateral resistivity capacity. So in the case of the lateral resistivity capacity is a higherly in a when we are choosing the 100 mm the diameter of the CFG. So these are the graph is explained the lateral load versus displacement curves of the various diameter of the CFG pipe. Few of the figures later with the fail. Okay, now the total displacement, it is most important. Now the numeric analysis has to be carried out by the plaxis reading, and with effectively 0.01 meters, okay, depth, and the finding out the stress distributions in the soils. The total displacement which we have to find out is a 15 mm from the applications of the load. So here is some of the dumbbell types of the stress concentrations has to be creating in this two part. Lateral displacements 0.1 meter, 0.2 meter, 0.3 meter, 0.4 meter. So now the results has to be most important thing is that when if I wanted to study about the lateral displacement versus the depth, the relation is mentioned of the CFG piles with influencing of the lateral displacement of single CFG pile with the variable depth. Second thing is that the stress concentrations, the numerical analysis with using the plaxis, the soil pressure distributions across the sections, soil pressure distributions, cross sections in the plaxis 3D. You have to see that 0 to 500 is a depth, and the lateral soil pressures in part of the KPA, it is a surrounding soils. We using the theta. Theta is equal to 0, theta is equal to 30, theta is equal to 60, and theta is equal to 90. What is the theta? The lateral load directions. Okay, lateral load directions. Here, in this case of the CFG pile, we applied the lateral load on a one directionals. When it is applied in one directionals, to do the axisymmetrical modeling, the stress concentrations on the surrounding soil, stress distributions, stress pressures, sorry, the soil pressures is creating. How much amount of the soil pressure is creating? To find out, we using the 0, 30, 60, and 90 is angle. And similarly, the 90 to 92 again the zero the same way. So you have to see this relationship between the lateral soil pressures versus depth. Again, the combination load V is equal to 0.3 VU, 0.5, 0.7, 0.3, 0.5, 0.7. Variable length of the length is equal to 245, length is equal to 280. Combined loading one. Okay, vertical loading versus lateral loading. Again, the combined loading of the CFG piles, ultimate lateral loading. These are the results of the output. V is equal to zero, and the CFG pile diameter 70 mm, and the length having the 175 mm. The ultimate the lateral load capacity. H is equal to 440, 460, 510, 580, and so on. So these are the results of the ultimate related load capacity. Now the results of the combination load, okay, the reversibles applied to the axial load, okay, application of the axial load, and the fix up the over the horizontal lateral load. In the previous case, we applied the horizontal load and fix up the axial load with the 4 increment. Similarly, here with the 3 increment of the H is equal to 0.3, 0.6, and 0.9. What is H? H is the ultimate lateral load. Okay, the relation has to be find out for the end bearing as well as the floating points. D is equal to 70 mm, L is equal to 175 mm. Okay, D is equal to 270 mm, L is equal to 210 mm. The relationship between the actual compression versus settlement. Okay, 245 mm length, 280 mm length. Axial compression load, settlement, the relation between the axial compression load versus settlement, D is equal to 70 mm, L is equal to 315 mm, H is equal to 0.3 HU, H is equal to 0.6 HU, H is equal to 0.9 HU. Here, floating, that's why the relationship between the load versus settlement is a non-linear behavior. And these are the output, the results of the single CFG piles. 70 mm, 175 mm, ultimate the axial compression load. Under the axial compression load, H is equal to 0, H is equal to 0.3, H is equal to 0.6, and H is equal to 0.9 H. So this amount of the load is going to be found. So the results based on this experiment, the ultimate the lateral load capacity of the CFG pile is increased with the increasing in a pile length. As pile length is increased from the 175 mm to 315 mm, the lateral load capacity is increased by the 94%. The ultimate lateral load on the CFG pile remains almost a constant after the L by D ratio of 4.5. The lateral load carrying the capacity of 100 mm diameter, CFG pile is 1.75 mm more than the 70 mm diameter. As per the numerical analysis, the lateral deformations become negligible after the depth of the 156 mm from the top pile top. The variable of the peak pressures distributions along the length and CFG piles can be idealizations as increase and the linear increase up to the depth of the 0.45 times the distance of the plane of the rotations, and it then the decrease to be the zero at the point of the rotations. The circular the CFG pile, the pressure distribution across the diameter is not uniform, but the maximum at the center and the minimum at the both edges. The axial load carrying capacity of the pile is decreased 3 to 5 times a lateral load 0.3 HU, 6 to 8% in a lateral load 0.6 HU, and 9 to 11% in lateral load 0.9 HU in a combination. The load to the lateral load and distributions is the relative to moment generations. The ultimate the lateral load increase with the increase the diameter of the CFG pile. The presence of the vertical load has had increased the lateral load capacity with the increasing L by D ratio, but influence of the vertical load decreased with increasing the soundness ratio of the CFG piles at all the vertical load level, the both the types of the CFG piles. And the last, the lateral load carrying capacity of the increasing 4 to 6%, 8 to 10%, and 11 to 30% event, the vertical load of the 0.3 VU, 0.5 VU, and 0.7 VU respectively. Now this is my part 2 is completing. Part 3, it is a research work to determination of the ultimate the lateral capacity of the Part 3 is actually compression test setup for the small CFG pile group. Here the size of the tank has to be increasing. Only the changes is that the loading frame is the same, LVDD is the same, the tank size is 1.5 meter by 0.5 meter by 0.5. Okay, and the number of the piles has to be increased. Okay, to increasing the number of the piles, what are the requirement? Tank, casing pipe, compaction rod, load cell, auger, jack. Okay, display unit we require. These are the some of the experiment work from the small group CFG pile. Okay, first of all, pour up to 500 mm the sand layers. Okay, then after pouring the soil, compacted properly. Okay, marking with the 50 mm and 50 mm. Install the CFG piles, apply the action. Here we use the heavy compaction rule to properly compact and evaporating the amount of the void presence in a soils. Normally, the arrangement of the column technology in the soft soils either may be a triangular pattern or either may be in a square pattern. So, some of the experiment work which we have to carry out in axial compression small group CFG pile model is already we done the single CFG pile, bunch of the two CFG piles with the 1.5D and the 2.5D, the shorter spacing, three group of the CFG pile, four group of CFG, six group of CFG pile. The number of the test experiment works from the 1 to 36. Okay, the loading condition is only the apply the compression load. The diameter is variable from the 50 mm to 70 mm. Okay, the length has been carried out from the 450 mm each and every experiment. So these are the variation between the stress versus settlement softly under the larger tank, and the ultimate the bearing capacity of the soft soil was we found at 53.59 kPa. Its behavior is non-linearly. It means that up to the 5 mm to 10 mm the settlement, the soil clay is maybe going to fail. Okay, so now relationship between the load versus settlement of the 50 mm and the 70 mm. The plate size 80 mm by 80 mm, tank size 1.5 mm by 1.5 mm. This figure, this is, near figure is explaining the FEM analysis with using the Plexus 3D. The below part is a 50 mm sand layer and this is my clay layer. The single CFG pile is a started and check its a load versus settlement relationship between of the 70 mm and the 50 mm. Case number 5 to 8, the relationship between the load versus settlement of 50 mm, 70 mm, L by D ratio 1.5 and the 2.5 of the two numbers of CFG pile. The three numbers of the CFG piles in a triangular pattern, the spacing is 1.5D and the 2.5D. So what is the spacing? Spacing, it is a center to center distance between the two CFG piles is a defined as a spacing. And this spacing is a directly relationship between the diameter. That's why we choosing the parameter of the 1.5D and the 2.5D. To reducing the boundary, but also we are not choosing the higher spacing ratio. So these are the result, your result between the load versus settlement curve of 50 mm diameter, 1.3 numbers of the CFG pile in along the directionals and across the directionals. Here the bearing ratio Q by Cu versus the settlement ratio, the relation has to be mentioned here. Axial displacement, lateral displacement and lateral displacement in a Y direction. When I applied the axial load on the group of the CFG piles, its a lateral displacement is also we have to study. This lateral displacement in the X directions to be found 2.40 mm is 2.40 mm in X directions and 1.40 mm in a Y directions. This value, it is very nominal comparisons to its vertical settlements of the actual displacement. Another experiment work of the four CFG pile together of the 50 mm and the 70 mm. This is the relationship between the load versus the settlement of the four numbers 1.5 center to center, 2.5 center to center, 70 mm, four numbers, 1.5 center to center, 2.5 center to center. These are the relationship between load versus settlement. And the FEM analysis, one thing is that all the piles are end bearing piles. That's why the relationship between the load versus settlement is a linearly in each and every cases. Another thing is we have to found that there are some particular interval, these rate of the load versus settlement is increasing, as well as we are going to study about the bearing ratio Q versus Cu and the settlement ratio S versus P. Based on this load versus settlement relationship, these are the output of the plexus of the four bunch of group: axial displacement vertically, lateral displacement in x, lateral displacement in y directional. Now the bunch, couple of the six group small CFG piles, small CFG pile groups, 50 mm, 1.5 D spacing, 2.5 D spacing of the 50 mm. Similarly, in a 70 mm and 1.5 D spacing and 2.5 D spacing. The relationship between the load versus settlement of 50 mm, six number of the CFG pile, 1.5 center to center, 2.5 center to center, six numbers of the 1.5 center to center, 70 mm, 2.5 center to center. Is the plexus output the results? The various these stress influence factors, various group of the CFG piles, the factors which is defined the ratio of the footing load for the treated cases, given the settlement of the footing load for and the untreated the cases, the same settlement. Here I am considered the SIP considered at 25 mm the settlement. The diameter of the CFG pile 50 mm, end bearing 70 mm, end bearing. The pattern is a triangular pattern. A spacing is a 1.5 D, 2.5 D. Area replacement ratio is a 9.19. Okay, and the SIF, the stress influence factor, is we have to find from the 7.67. Now the reasons for the method are the usually estimate the failure of the shallow foundations based on the load versus settlement curve. But if there is a no disintegrate the failure patterns of the foundation, the ultimate loading value is obtained by the tangential increment methods, TIM. Ultimate bearing capacity of the subsoil was the 53.59 kPa. The bearing capacity of soil, based on the impact of the represented footing measured and its effect of the CFG piles by S by B ratio on the enhancement ratio, SIF, it is observed that first, the SFR, the ratio increased marginally with the four CFG piles and a six group CFG pile, 50 mm diameters. However, the SIF is a roughly constant, the 10 mm settlement. The main parameters influencing the actions of the rigid footing settlement is soft clay. The reinforcement by the group CFG pile is the area replacement ratio. Other the parameters which are also depending upon the area replacement ratio, the spacing and the L by D ratio, both significantly play the role enhancing the bearing capacity of the subsoil. Therefore, the compression of the group CFG pile contribution the less than 19% total settlement, while the penetrations of the piles and the compression of the soft soils below the pile tips contribution nearly the 70% of the total settlement. The soft soil within the lower one third, the pile length was subjected to the compression along with the soft soil below the pile tips. The influence depth below the CFG pile tips was about one more. The width of the pile treated the area, the difference in settlement on the plate was the small, and the lateral displacement of a soft soil below the base on the plate was negligible. Another experiment we have already carried out, that is a lateral, but due to this case I am not going to be study for that. I am just carried out another various models. So all these experiments we have to do analysis with the plexus model. Now normally when I am going to apply this CFG pile into the real field, so I am choosing the one embankment having the width is 28 meters and its height is 4.9 meters. The slope of this embankment is 1:1.5 meters. The geogrid layer is applied, hence the soil strata is divided into the majorly the four part. Soil strata is not cushions 0.5, so silty clay 3.5 meters, soft clay 10 meters, clay is 6, and the spacing is carried out from this part to another part. So now this Blaxis model, I'm just selecting the axial symmetrical model to analysis of the part. In this part, the embankment field geosynthetic enhanced geosynthetic with the enhanced foam columns as well as the horizontal displacement of the CFG piles respectively. The sand cushion is applied, composite foundation, CFG pile and enhanced foam columns reinforcement zone, soft clay and the supporting courses and the six. This is my sixth part. Enhanced foam columns, the CFG pile. So here in this study, I would compare the CFG pile the behaviors as well as the enhanced foam column the behaviors under the embankment. Choosing this 50 mm and 24.9 meter of the height, only the part to easily evaluate the value. Now they are the choosing of the geosynthetic type SG0550 and can only the extended. The deformation, the stiffness of this material is 118.9 kilonewton per meter is chosen. The material property which you have to consider for the analysis, numerical analysis of this embankment, the parameters embankment, the bulk density is 18.3, the saturated density is 21.15, the modulus of the elasticity is 16,000 kPa, the poison is 0.34, cohesion is 5, angle of internal friction is 26, permeability is 0.02, cushion sands 19, the saturated density 19, modulus of the elasticity is equal to 2, considering for the 22,500, poison ratio is 0.33, cohesion 1.5, angle of internal friction 24. Similarly, the all the other property of the models has to be carried out. Now the results is the important part here. If you see the influence of the length of the enhanced foam column versus a CFG pipes, the relationship between the pressures versus the settlement, how much amount of the pressure is acting in the soils, and the settlement has to be found out. So enhanced stone columns, you know, having the soil enhanced stone columns with the pressure of the 250 kilonewton per meters, okay, the capacity, right, and the 14 meters length. So we got the value. It is the maximums at the maximum the settlement, and we got the less 5,000 kilonewton per meter. These are my the variable parameters. Variables parameters of the modulus of the elasticity, and this modulus of the elasticity of the variability, we got the difference result of the pressure versus settlement. Now the relationship between the distance and the settlement of the enhanced foam column versus the CFG pile supported embankment. The embankment with the distance, cross section embankment. Relation between the distance and settlement of the enhanced foam columns and the CFG pile supported embankment. So you have to get that the amount of the CFG piles, their settlement is comparatively less than to the enhanced foam columns with respect to its length. Here the zero is considering that at a center, and the distance from 0 to 12 meter, which is a par distance apart from toward the embankment will soils. The relationship between the enhanced foam column and CFG piles with the vertical and horizontal deformation with the variables length. Here the length is a variable and later deformations has to be variables. So what is the basically difference between that? Horizontal, the behaviors of that. Vertical, the behaviors of that. Here this average CFG pile has to be considered. The length of the CFG pile 12 meter, 30 meters and 14 meter has been selected, and the lateral deformations of the CFG pile has to be found out. In the case of the CFG pile is applied in embankment, the soil arching effect has to be created. This soil arching is creating because of the CFG pile. It is a semi-rigid material, Okay, it's a nature. It is toward the rigidity with respect to the time, and the soil is very flexible. So due to this case, the stress is stress as well as the resistivity is creating that effect is identified as a soil arching effect. The relation between the arching effect versus the subsoil settlement. The arching effect, it is in terms of the So 0 to 1.3 mm. And subsoil settlement from the 0 to 30 to 40 mm, the CFG pile 12 meter length to 14 meter length has to be found out. So these are my soil arching effect. Okay, now the model is. I don't have more time, so come to the part. Now similarly, I am just selecting the soil model, okay, and apply this models in a building for the Plexus 3D and apply the Al Centro earthquake modeling. Here the boundary conditions of the soil, considering the 160 meter by 40 meter by 5 meter building element is considering as a five floor and basement, 10 meter wide and 18 meter height, two basement of the depth has been selected. Here the another thing is that when I selecting the material property for the soft soil is as a small model, sandy soil, and CFG pile is considered as a linear elastic model. This is the Plexus modeling and some of the property which I have to mention for the solving the numerical analysis of the buildings under the earthquake load. So the results is output for 2x2 group. Here the influence the frequency parameters of the Young's modulus versus the spacing diameter and necessary frequency we have to find out. Similarly, 3x3 groups, the result is there. Now the parameters is a fix. One parameter is a fix is a soil Young's modulus, S by D ratio is a variable and necessary frequency we have to find. So these are the output the results of the frequency of the pile groups, foundations in the CFG pile, result output. Now the pile head response in under the SR relations is when we selecting the ES is equal to 10 raised to 4 kilonewton per meter square. The relationship of the pile head response for displacement, ES is equal to 10 raised to 4 in a 2x2 response in a inner side, external part and as well as the inner part of the CFG pile. Again the pile head response, 3x3 CFG piles, ES versus acceleration and ES versus the displacement response. Another result for the pile head response, CFG pile head ratio and displacement is a precise pile head response. So result is presented here, the based on the three dimension FEM analysis, non-linear dynamic analysis for the interrelation of the soil particle group foundation system. This present study effect of the CFG pile group configurations on seismic soil pile kinematic interactions by measuring 2x2 foundations and 3x3 CFG pile foundations systems with the different soil properties and the pile spacing ratio include the soil properties affected the pile accelerations, pile head displacement, seismic interactions of the soil pile system generally. Although the largely spaced CFG pile group having a significantly large pile head the response than closely spaced CFG pile group, general effect of the pile spacing ratio, seismic response of the soil pile systems are insignificant. The effect number of the piles on the pile head accelerations are not significant, while the effect of the number of the pile head displacement are considerable. But the consequences of the pile spacing ratio and the L-centric installations. The bearing capacity of single CFG piles composite foundations was greater than the free single CFG piles in general. The bearing capacity of the between the soil and the pile CFG piles the composite foundations was greater than that the nature of the foundations. The soil pressures and its a group effect of the GRPS, the embankment was investigated using the three-dimensional finite element modeling. Using this work, the elasticity modulus of the G-signality enhancement contributes significantly to capacity and the stiffness of the enhanced stone column. For the stiffness, encasement and the confinement, the pressure creating the stone columns are the higher. The CFG file mix graded the effect on the stiffness. It found that CFG piles can combinedly minimize the settlement and lateral deformations. In terms, they minimize the settlement and lateral displacement. The CFG piles reinforcement improve the efficiency compared to the CFG enhanced concrete. In additionally, it concludes that the pile effect significantly influenced stress distribution percentage between the piles and sounding. Based on the stress concentration ratio, measure the equipment. The larger the pile length can be the distribution, more the significant the stress. The result shows the subsurface settlement mainly affected about the ground soil arching, but has the little effect on the neighboring the soil arching. The wave transmission effect in the center is higher than the shoulders and even through the higher soil arching, both location is about the same. These are the few references of this research. Thank you. Now I request you to participate. If you have any questions, please.
Thank you very much, sir, Professor Nirav, to share your valuable inputs towards to geotechnical engineering. Now I kindly request to the participants, if you have any questions or doubt, through WhatsApp chat or the via chat box over here, you can raise the questions. As such, the 4 days has already been passed for this FDP session only tomorrow. That is the last day which has been remaining, and there is only 2 sessions are there. So questions are welcomed if you have. So there is no question from the participants in WhatsApp chat as well as over here in the chat box. So on the behalf of the participants, behalf of the Government Engineering College Dahod, from all, we thankful to you, Professor Nirav, to share their research work, some advancement related to geotechnical engineering. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
So, all the participants, let us be quit right now. We'll meet tomorrow morning at 10. Okay. Thank you.